Greetings. Okay. Yesterday was All Fools Day, but it looks like All Fools is like gone into the second. As I sit here alone, waiting for someone to appear, scanning the news and seeing everything. For years I have seen a few things, like I said this and it happened. And nobody likes to hear it because the outer reality will not accept that you have established yourself in any kind of power. You must not establish yourself as anything above anyone else. But in my internal reality, which is my external reality, I have seen this pattern and I have claimed it. I only tell everyone else so that they can claim it, so we can help each other clean up this reality. But this is gonna be like mind-blowing. But what if I was right in 2017, 2018 when I said, this guy is Trump, he's not locking up Hillary. Trust the plan, my ass. Why is Q against Edward Snowden? So that the whole reality doesn't trust him. Why is Q against Alex Jones? So the whole reality doesn't trust him. All right, okay. So I don't trust you, Q. But then you make these great movies and you connect the dots and you tell me, oh, it's all done. It's all being done. And then I get excited and I start to like, oh yeah, it's really happened. You know, don't trust anyone outside there, but trust that something good is happening. And I went along with that. But I'm going to tell you something that is very, 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 very controversial and will blow your mind so that you won't even listen to me. I have been listening to Kim Gogan for a few years through her filters, which is Tommy Williams. I'm not going to get into those stories, but I agree with most of what they're saying, except for when it comes to their dark overlord program of bad guys, which I just leave that alone. It's like we all have those bad guy programs because nobody knows how Mars looks and nobody knows how time machines works in the true essence. And all of these things we have to take, like cloning and all of these things. We have to just like, okay, it must be possible because they did clone a sheep and we accept it. And then we're starting to see body doubles and stuff like that. But coming back to Kim. Kim has been saying for the last couple of weeks that Trump is a piece of shit, a black sun like the rest of them. And you cannot be a billionaire on this planet unless you're with the program. And I see this to be true. The second that, you know, those guys like Escobar, they ran the cocaine racket, the whole U.S. government, DEA, CIA, media was hunting this guy down to make sure that he does not get into the billionaire club. And when years later, we learned that these people are actually fighting for us, using the same things the CIA and them were doing to make their money. They don't want any competition. So you can just like go into your, right program. But you know what? Yeah, I'm right. I seen it for myself. I know. You know, those who know me. Don't trust those guys. But Kim has been saying that Trump is a black sun. What is a black sun? The opposite of light suns. And she saved his ass because she wanted to work with him a few times. And what happened was that she, I don't know how much money was given, but I think it's like, I heard Tank say the other day, $500 billion, $500 billion. And they were supposed to get back 2%. That was the deal. And whether it was legal or not, an agreement is an agreement. And they were supposed to get the 2%. And their words are the 2% was for all of us for humanitarian projects. So do your calculation and figure what 2% is, but it's quite a bit of money. And Trump reneged. Now, why would she tell everyone who is trusting Trump, which is closer to the truth, then, and to go against all the QAnon patriots, Trump team of being good, glorious, Saint Germain, and all of these bulk things that they call time machine traveler, Byron Trump being genius, all of these things. Why would she, unless she was the absolute opposite evil? But then she's saying, I ain't releasing any money to these people anymore. She has been coming up with a story of the generals. The five-star generals, your admirals, the ones you hero worship as protectors of your country. And realizing they're not protecting our country, they're keeping the wars going. I just saw an article a while ago. They don't want to pull out of Afghanistan because of contractors. They have a contract with the war machine to perpetuate war. And the more we know, is the more we know this is true. So I'm not being in a political mind of saying who is what. I'm just like, give you this story. So let us say, let us all agree, just for the moment of agreement, because, you know, the block comes and you don't want to hear it, that Trump was actually one of them. And he was put in there to say, okay, we're going to take it to a point where we extract everything we possibly can. In all possibilities, we need to build our underground bunkers. It's not finished. The world is waking up. And we're just going to put on a show like we're rescuing them. And then they tell us everything we're going to be rescued so we don't revolt. We divide ourselves even more, red and blue. And then they rig the election, knowing Biden is going to steal it, putting in a fake Biden, playing it out with slurs and stupidity, giving us the worst things to show us Biden doesn't work. But where's Trump? All right. Now, Kim didn't say this. None of us would really know. Because every indication is that he, or were presented with, is all of these bad guys were taken out, but no evidence is given to us. And I've always said, Hillary and Obama can be in their underground bunker, and their clone or their actor or their CGI stays up on the surface, tweeting away and blabbering about justice and who should and who what. And what if all of it was a show to control us? And this is what else Kim said. They were off of Florida with some nukes or some Scud missiles, and they had planned to set it off. But she has the master codes. The quantum computer sees everything. And she stopped it. Okay, who's she? Who is she? But she says she's in charge of the trust. She says she's the absolute top general of the whole plan. She says this. And everyone else who doesn't know it thinks that, oh, this is another scam, because we got so many scams on us. So if this scam, the real scammers were scamming us to tell us we're the good guys, and no one's paying attention to the real good guys, and she's stopping it, and she's laughing. She says, like, yeah, I just stopped them from blowing up the world. And, oh, yeah, they keep calling and wanting a meeting. And when they come, they go, give us back the keys. And she says, no. She leaves the answering machine. I pick up a call, and there's a beep, and beep, 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 beep. And laughing at them and taking it like a joke. What if all of that is true? I want that to be true. I'm going to tell you then. I won't tell you nothing, because I know how it works. We are the creators of our reality. And I definitely wanted a woman to be in charge, because I was tired of the men fuckery. I really did. It's playing out. I wanted somebody just like her, a smart cookie, that could take over the master computer and delete all these assholes. rich assholes, all thinking that we are stupid and we're in the sheep farm. You cannot be a billionaire unless you're playing with them. Okay, I don't want to hear no emotional what if. I'm a deep thinker, and I've been saying this for years. And maybe I created this timeline. I don't know. You can blame it all on me. You can blame it on me. But you can't, because you don't believe that you have this ability. A couple years ago, I went into this, and I said, how do you save this planet? It's not self-destruct. How do you save this planet? But Jesus said, all this you can do and more. And I go, okay. If I don't follow their program and don't read their Bible and take the limitations on all of these things that were presented to us, I would just like, Bashar says, be real, be your true self. Do your highest vibrational thing. What do you want to do? And I go, I want to save the world. Who am I? Well, Jesus said, who do I think I am? Bashar said, I must think who I am. And I go, okay, but all of you telling me to be nice to you because you're full of convoluted bullcrap stories. And I don't buy that shit. And you don't like when I tell you I don't buy that shit. Just boom, 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 boom. And it's like, you come back at me and tell me, oh, you're not going to heaven. I said, but that's their program. That's the program all of you have been following. All right? And so I stopped communicating with the program's people, especially the ones I love, uncle, aunts, mom, sister, brother. I love you all, but I'm not going to go along with your program. So I stay away because I don't want to be in your judgment field. Okay, so that's me. I'm just telling you, I really, really said, and I started to absolutely cut myself off from everyone by telling them that you are all gods. Oh, forget the word G-O-D. Let us start using this as programs. I am a program. What is my program said to do? Just like how you program genetically dogs to round up sheep or dig moles or hunt birds. Those are all programs. It's a human vessel. We just think we know more and put clothes on and cook our food and prepare it. The other animals kind of do it in a different way without tools. And they do really well. But the domesticated animals are programmed by us. We're their gods. G-O-D. Dogs. G-O-D. Reverse. So why can't our gods be the programmer of us? Thou shalt not. Thou shalt do. Thou shalt... Wow. Okay. So I said, you know what? I have more gods outside of me. And who want to call me heathen? I love Jesus more than all of you. I know who murdered Jesus. It's the thoughts of not being murdered Jesus. Who does he think he is? Stone him, spit on him. That's disgusting. If a man wants to live and feel like he's something, just leave him alone. But you know what? I'm not going into that negative program of why you don't think so, because you're outside of me and you're my reality. So I used to think that way too, so I have to accept it and forgive it. So this morning I knew beyond the shadow of a doubt. I woke up and I go, anything I want in this program I can do, as long as I know it's true and it's good for all of me's use. And I don't see nothing wrong with this. If I was to prove to everybody on this day, you're Trumps an evil, malevolent bastard who planned this, not many people would like it, because you really like this guy, or you really hate this guy, but I don't really like you because the way you hated him was the wrong way. The few people that said Trump's a program too, I said, all right, I don't want to hear you right now, because he's the only hope to get rid of this human trafficking. I don't see any other way. Because I'm not believing in myself yet. I'm still waiting on the outer people to do shit. You know, the heroes and every story. Oh, the military went in, SEAL Team 6 did this and all that. You're just actors in my movie. You're just actors in my movie. Yeah, you're just actors in my movie. So today, I feel like they're all gone underground. And something tells me the governors and the rest of them are not there. The low-ranking ones, the ones that didn't play the game, will be there. But all of the serious ones. And as I'm reading reports of class action suits, people standing up, I put this People's Court on Facebook. Not one like and not one comment. And I said, what is this? Because they don't want you to know you can create a court. When you tell, when I say sovereign, they have programmed you to think sovereign is a rebel that doesn't need a government. It's like, come on, guys. Let's get this thing straight. Anyway, I'm not pandering to your belief system anymore. I'm making statements.